Hi, my name is Alan, and if you're watching this video, you're probably going to Rio de Janeiro for the Olympics in August, or just plain interested in Brazil. I am leaving this afternoon for New York City, where I'm catching a flight to Rio, and I'll arrive there tomorrow morning. Flights right now are pretty cheap to Brazil due to it being the off-season and a lot of other factors, which we'll discuss later. Just to give you a little background, I went to school in Rio de Janeiro back in 1986 for a year, and I later moved to Salvador, Bahia in 1992, where I lived for 5 years. I visited Brazil quite frequently since then, and I maintain contact with a lot of friends and associates I have in Brazil. The objective of this video is to give tourists a feel for Rio and what they can expect when they get there. I'm not really focusing on the games themselves, but what the international tourists should expect while at the games. An estimated 400,000 to 500,000 tourists will descend on Rio at the beginning of August for the Olympics, and we'll actually be witnessing history as this is the first time the Olympics are held anywhere in South America, though they were held in Latin America, in Mexico City in 1968. Now, overall, we'll just try to give everybody a good perspective about what's going on in Brazil, some tips to get by in Brazil, and what to expect when you get there. So tomorrow morning, I will be in Rio de Janeiro, and I'll be filming probably from the moment that we get at the airport, how to catch the airport bus to Copacabana, where we're gonna be staying. So I hope to enjoy this adventure, and I hope that it's valuable to you as you're watching. Good morning. We just got to Rio de Janeiro. We had a 9.5 hour flight from New York City on American Airlines. It was a great flight. Food was good, service was good. Probably the best U.S. carrier to Rio. That's one of the best flights I had to Rio. Behind us are the ATM machines, and I think that's the best. There's also some exchange places where you can get money, but I just use the ATM machine, no problem. The ATM machine is at the other end of the terminal that we arrived at. And we got some information for the bus. We're gonna take the local, it's an airport bus, and from the airport to Copacabana, it's 14 reais, which is less than $5. So we're gonna go get on that bus right now. Hopefully we won't have any problems. I know Rio, I haven't been here in a while, it is kind of violent, so hopefully we won't be shot at or kidnapped or mugged or anything. So here we go, okay. Okay, we just got outside, and the bus behind us goes to Copacabana. You have to pay the bus driver when you get on, not at the kiosk here. This bus is full, so we're gonna catch the next bus, which should be here in 20 minutes. See you then. Okay, we made it to the hotel. It's a little bit rainy today. The bus, my experience with it right now is that I wouldn't take the bus unless you're traveling alone. If you're traveling with more than two people, it's probably more economical and a lot quicker just to take a taxi. Plus they let us off at the Orla, which means at the beach, at the shore, and we had to walk about 8 blocks with our suitcases. So other than that, everything is going well. We got a good city tour on the bus, so my friend was able to see what Rio is all about. We're gonna go out and have some lunch, and our room is gonna be ready at 2 o'clock, so we'll see you then. Okay, we just got settled into our room, took a shower, feel good. The room took a little while to get ready. It was ready at 2 o'clock, but they gave us a triple size. There's two of us, so the triple size is good, even though I had originally ordered a double size room with two beds, but we have a little bit more space. We got a room here in the front, hot shower, everything's working except the internet. The internet's a little bit spotty, so we might have to go downstairs, but the breakfast is included, and right now we're going to check out the pool, which they have on the roof. The location is really good. It's right in the center of Copacabana, about a 10-minute walk to the beach, but it's in a nice neighborhood, so I would recommend staying here. Came out to about $65 a night. had breakfast at the hotel, they had a nice spread of fruit, eggs, bread, everything else. And we're gonna head out pretty soon. We're gonna go to Maracana Stadium, where they held some World Cup games. They're gonna hold some of the Olympic games, so they won't let teams play there until after the Olympics. But they do have a museum there, and they have a tour, so maybe we can go around the stadium and visit that. And then after that, we're gonna go to the Olympic complex. And today's a little cloudy right now, but it should clear up. It's gonna be about 70 degrees. And I got basically what I wear in Rio at any time. I got, you know, no jewelry, no watches. I got a money belt, flip-flops, and of course I got deep boots off to protect from the Zika virus. So see you around Rio. Bye-bye. Maracana Stadium, and it's closed due to security reasons for the Olympics. But to get here, we took two subways. From where we're staying, right across the street, there's a subway station. We got to Botafogo, which is two stations away, and then we took another train all the way to Maracana. So from the Zona Sul to here, you can come by subway, which is pretty easy, very easy actually. So right now I think we're going to head over to Olympic Village, try to get over there and see if we can take some pictures and hang out there. But unfortunately this is closed. If we're open, there's a museum here, and you can also go on a tour, they told us. I'm not sure, but the guy at the hotel told us you can go on a tour. It's about $12 and actually walk around on the field. But it won't open up again until November after the Olympics. Unfortunately, we won't be able to go on there today. We'll see you later. Okay, right now we are at the BRT, by the BRT buses. We're at the Alvorada station. This station you have to get to take the BRT bus to the Olympic complex. And the bus, it only costs about $1, but you need this BRT pass that you purchase here. You have to get to this Alvorada station. It's in a neighborhood called Baja de Tijuca. So anywhere in Copacabana, Ipanema, just catch the bus to Alvorada and Baja de Tijuca. Get this pass for the BRT bus. It takes 10 minutes and you'll be at the Olympic Village. We got to the Olympic Village, actually the Olympic Park, a little while ago, about an hour or so ago. It took a while to get here, a little complicated. Hopefully they'll get it worked out, the transportation, tourists coming here. But as you can see, a lot of stuff is still under construction. They got a long ways to go, but everybody's told me so far that it is going to be ready in time. But I've seen nothing completed, from the bus system to the park, the stuff going on downtown and Copacabana. They got a little ways to go, but they should get there. We'll be right back. say, today is Thursday. It's a beautiful day. We got up early, had breakfast, and now we're at a place called Lago do Machado. We took the subway here. We're going to catch a bus up the hill to where the Christ the Redeemer statue is and hang out there for a couple hours. See you up there. Bye-bye. Okay, we took a local bus to Lago do Machado, from Lago do Machado, up the hill to where we catch a van. The guy on the bus said there's trains that go up, which I was aware of, but there's a 2-hour wait, so it's quicker just to catch a van because there's a road that goes up all the way to the top of the Corcovado, the Christ Redeemer. So we're going to do that now. We're going to buy a ticket at the booth behind us, and then we're going to catch a van. So you want to show the booth over? Got the tickets, they're 30 reais. They're round trip, but the van's gonna leave in 5 minutes. And we still have to pay to get into the Christ the Redeemer, but the tickets are less than $10 round trip, so hold on to your ticket. We'll see you up there. To a viewpoint where we could see over top of the city before we got here. Now we're at the ticket office to go up to the Corcovado, the Christ the Redeemer, and it's about 38 reais, which is about a little bit over $10. Now we got to catch a van to go to the top. They never used to have this before, it used to be free, but now you have this point right here where you have to get a ticket for 38 reais and then catch a van. We made it to the top. We're at the effort. It's a breathtaking view up here. And you have to get a separate ticket, which is like $10, like I said, but it's worth it. There's a lot of people up here. But if you can get up here, you should. Thank you. cost 76 reais, about 20 some bucks to get here. A little bit of a line, but not bad. But we had to get a taxi from the Christ the Redeemer statue over there in Corcovado to here, because the bus was very complicated. It was only about, it was less than $10, about $8 to get here, so it wasn't bad. So we're going to go all the way to the top right now and see up there. The sugar loaf, and you could walk around behind it. There's platforms on top, but if you walk around, there's trails that you can go down. There's picnic benches if you want to bring some drinks and have, you know, have a little picnic. And the view is absolutely gorgeous. The sun is just about to go down. My battery's running out, so I thought I'd take one last video before I leave. Here to Paraty. It's about 4.5 hours south of Rio by bus. It's a nice city. We haven't gotten out too much yet. There's a lot of posadas around here, so if you do come to Paraty, you are going to find a place to stay. It should be a problem. The price to get here was about a little bit over $20 US. If you want to get a taxi, there is somebody who will take you here. I'll put the information down. It's 600 AI, so it's a little bit less than $200. We'll take you here and just drop you off. So if you have two or three people, it should be fine. If you want, if you come early, he'll stay here all day, wait for you. Then it would be 850 reais, which would be a little bit over $200. So that's another option. So right now we're going to go into town and get a bite to eat. Tomorrow we're going to take some nice pictures around town, and hopefully the weather will be nice. It should be. In July and August, it is pretty cold. So if you do come that time of year, it's the winter, and it's not really good beach weather. But it's still a nice place to stay. And the other thing is we're staying at a place called Princesa do Mar, and the guy who owns it for some reason charged my credit card before I got here and added a cleaning fee, which I've never seen before. And he added the wrong fee. It was supposed to be 16 reais and he added like 30 reais. So right now I wouldn't recommend coming here, but it's a nice little place. It's close to the ocean, so we're gonna check everything out and see you later. Bye. Okay, we're in the colonial section of Paraty, which is located in the extreme southern part of Rio State on the ocean. During the colonial period, the 1500s to the early 1800s, this was a main port for exporting gold from Brazil. And today, it's mostly a tourist attraction. There's a lot of artists around here, and old buildings have been converted into posadas and stores. Around the edges of Paraty, there's about 90 beaches and there's 60 islands you can visit also. So a lot of things to do here. If you're into ecology, ecological adventures, there's adventure tours you could do, there's trips through the mountains, there's kayaking, and scuba diving. So there's a lot to do here. We're at the end of the pier in Paraty. There's a bunch of boats. The smaller boats are at the other end of the pier that you could contract for a day. It's kind of expensive. You need a lot more people. These boats at this end of the pier, the very end, are the bigger boats. And it's between 30 and 50 reais, about between like 9 to 15 bucks. They go out for 5 hours. The one that we just talked to, they stop on four stops on a few different islands. And they have everything you need. They have bars, tables. Looks like a fun time. It'd be great to come out here. If the weather's nice, come out and have a day on the islands. Unfortunately, we can't go. We got too much other stuff going on, but very good option and very inexpensive. We decided to take the schooner. It's called Banzai, the schooner that we took. It's a 6-hour ride. It's 50 reais, which is less than $20. And it makes four stops along the way. We already stopped at a place called Blue Lagoon. This is a public beach, but it's only accessible by boat. So boat has everything. It's got a kitchen on it. It's got, if you want to order drinks, you can bring a backpack with food, spend the whole day. It's very relaxing, very nice. It's background music. Perfect day on the ocean. temperature's perfect, everything's nice. So I highly recommend you get out of the schooner. We just stopped, we made one more stop, probably our final stop before we head back to the port. I picked up some coconut water, a little bit of vodka I put in it, and everybody here is having a good time. It's later on in the afternoon. Tomorrow, we're gonna get up early and head to Petrópolis. So we gotta go through Rio de Janeiro to get to Petrópolis. We have the 6 o'clock, so we're enjoying our last couple hours here in Petrópolis, in Paraty. We're in front of the main church in Paraty that dates back to the colonial period. And around this area, it's very low sea level, so it floods when the tide is high or when there's a full moon. The streets are all cobblestone dating back to the 19th century, and they have to stay here. They're not allowed to put new blue streets on, and cars are not allowed in the city either. Last night we arrived in Petrópolis, which is an hour and a half from Rio bus ride. Pretty easy, pretty quick ride. There's always bus tickets available. We left Paraty in the morning. We wanted to leave early in the morning, but there were no bus tickets because it was a holiday weekend. It was Corpus Christi. My advice if you do go to Paraty is make sure that you have a round trip ticket either by bus, somebody waiting for you by taxi, or there are flights to Paraty also, but just make sure before you leave Rio that you have a way to get back to Rio. And there is no direct route from Paraty to Petrópolis, so you have to go through Rio. The other thing is make sure there's nice weather. We had 3 days of great weather, but the forecast is for the next 7 days of really bad weather. So this time of year, June, July, August, you never know what you're gonna get into. So right now we're gonna go visit Imperial Museum in Petrópolis and the house of Carlos Dumont, who Brazilians say is the father of aviation. So we're gonna find out what the heck's going on with that because everyone told me it was the Wright brothers. So we're gonna get to the bottom of this. So let's get going. Okay, we just finished the tour of the Santos Dumont house. And there's a nice movie that we saw afterwards. And it was a pretty good tour, pretty interesting. They still haven't convinced me that Santos Dumont invented the plane. He may have been the first to fly. There's a lot of debate. If you ask a Brazilian, they are gonna say he was the first, he invented the plane. But the tour was good. It was only a couple dollars. Well worth the visit. When you come here to Petrópolis, I think you can come on, there's some tours that leave Rio and you can just come for the day. That sounds like the best way to do it actually. Or you can spend the night, spend a couple days here, spend the night if you like. There's a lot of nice hotels. Just make reservations ahead of time. So we're gonna head off to the Imperial Museum right now. See you there. Okay, we just visited the Imperial Museum, which is in the downtown historical section of Petrópolis. And basically it was a summer home, weekend home for the imperial family. Dom João was a Portugal emperor who came from Portugal to flee from Napoleon, his attacking army. They came to Rio de Janeiro, set up their court here. When he went back to Portugal, his son Dom Pedro stayed in Brazil, and then he declared independence. He became the first emperor. And behind me is his son, Dom Pedro II, and the museum is behind up on the hill there. It's a nice, very nice museum, a lot of nice artifacts and paintings and stuff. Very, very well worth the effort to come and visit. So get a pan around and get another view of the rest of the place. This is our last day in Brazil. We're still in Petrópolis. We're gonna take a walk around the neighborhood, catch a few more sights, and take a bus back into Rio, and then catch our flight tonight. I was watching the news. As far as Zika goes, it's kind of weird. People, there's more hysteria outside of Brazil than in Brazil. There's not many people talking about it. You'd think they'd give more information at the hotels, maybe some pamphlets in English about how to avoid it. But basically, I think you just bring bug spray and wear a long sleeve. You know, if you're worried about it, wear long sleeve shirts and everything. But nobody here is really talking about it. I didn't feel there were many mosquitoes or many threats of Zika, in Rio at least. When we were in Paraty, I did see a lot of mosquitoes, feel a lot of mosquitoes around me. But it wasn't bad, nobody's talking about it. And this normal crime, as has always been in Brazil, you just gotta watch yourself. Last night I saw a report that there were some people from the Spanish delegation, some athletes, that got held up in Rio, so that's always gonna be an issue, whether it's Olympics or not. So you just gotta watch yourself with the crime. But Brazil's fun, you have a good time here. Hopefully you get out of Rio, take some side trips. Most people are gonna probably stay in the Zona Sul, which is Copacabana and Ipanema. And I don't know how it's gonna be an issue with people getting from there back and forth to the Olympic venue, which is about an hour south of Copacabana and Ipanema. So that's definitely gonna be a challenge for the local authorities. And they're still working on the infrastructure, construction of mass transit. So if you can, take mass transit. The subway system's very good. Use mass transit as much as possible. I try to avoid taxis in Rio. It's gonna be, like I said, it's gonna be a lot of congestion, so. But you'll have fun. Rio's fun. Try to get out of the city, try to enjoy as much as you can, and be prepared. Have a good time. It's been 3 weeks since I've returned from Rio, and lately Rio has been in the headlines, but for all the wrong reasons. The issues of Zika, crime, and infrastructure continue to be in the spotlight almost every day. I recently read that there's a good possibility that the proposed subway line from Ipanema to the Olympic site will not be completed, which will be a major issue, as I mentioned, as most of the tourists will be in Ipanema and Copacabana and need to get to Barra da Tijuca, where the Olympic site is. And even if the line is completed, a lot of engineers I read don't think it would be safe because to ride the system because there won't be enough days to test it. I also read that some of the athletes have decided not to participate in the Olympics due to Zika and safety concerns. And I read just yesterday that a jaguar was killed by Brazilian army because he escaped during an Olympic torch ceremony in Manaus. So everything is going on there. Crime is probably not on the rise in Rio, I don't believe so, but since the spotlight is getting brighter on Rio, with the Olympics coming up, I guess like 5 or 6 weeks from now, it's coming more to the forefront and grabbing more attention. So again, just be vigilant while you're out. Don't wander off to places that don't have a lot of people around. Don't go out with expensive jewelry and watches. Stay out of the favelas. And if you do get held up or approached by people that are dangerous or violent, just don't resist. You know, give them what they want. Your life is more important than anything. I do have some more detailed information on Brazil and on the Olympics. Just go to Blogger and you could type in the World Cup tips for travelers to Brazil 2014 or Rio Olympics 2016, what to know before you go, and I'll put the information below here. Okay, as for taxis, with the local taxis in Rio, for simplicity's sake, there's bandeira um, bandeira dois. So the bandeira um is when there's a one on the flag, and that's from 6 a.m. in the morning until 9 p.m. at night. That's the lower rate. After 9 p.m. on holidays and Sundays, it's the flag two, which is a slightly higher rate. So just make sure during the day that it is on bandeira um, or the one for the flag. Otherwise, you'll be taken advantage of. I do have an acquaintance in Rio. His name is Rodrigo, and I'll leave his phone number below, and he could also be contacted on WhatsApp. His English is a little spotty, but at least he's somebody you can rely on. And he might also be able to take you to Paraty or Petrópolis. And I'll also leave the information on another guy who took me to the bus station. His name is Mendez. He also doesn't speak any English, but you might be able to get a hold of him through the hotel that I stayed at, since that's where he works out of. And if you want to try something else, if you're into paragliding or if you would like to try it, a friend of mine, he could set you up where you can go paragliding with him. He has a TripAdvisor certificate of excellence. He's fluent in English, and he has very reasonable prices starting at as low as $100. Although during the Olympics, the Olympic Committee, IOC, whatever it is, they've prohibited paragliding around the Olympic site or anywhere around the metropolitan Rio area due to safety concerns and terrorists and stuff like that. So you might have to go farther outside of the city, or if you happen to be in Rio after the Olympics, you can go with him. So I'll leave his contact also. Another thing, I think it'd be good to download some apps on Rio to get around and tour sites and places to go and things to do. That'd be good to have on your phone. And finally, if you need a SIM card for data or voice and messaging, I can give you some information on that. It's good to have a SIM card as you're going to be out all day. You're going to be at the Olympic sites, and internet is a little spotty sometimes, even if you go to a place that does have internet. Some of the hotels aren't always good. But while you're out at the Olympic sites and you want to get into contact with somebody or post a picture or something, it'd be good to have a SIM card that does have that you could use anytime while you're in Brazil, either just for data or for voice messaging and data. So I'll leave some information on that also. And finally, please like and share this video. I haven't done too many, so I'd like to get out there. And feel free to add any comments or questions that you may have. I'll be happy to answer them and do the best I can to give you any information that you need on your trip, on Brazil, anything I could do to help. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoy your travels wherever you may wind up. Have a good day.